Distinguished colleague, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano is wearing a very nice, fashionable jacket today, black jacket today.
Thank you, Mr. President. Magandang hapon po. May I ask a couple of clarificatory questions to our esteemed and very learned colleague, popularly known as kapatid ng ating mga bayan, Tol Tolentino. May I ask some questions?
Willingly, Mr. President, to the former Secretary of the Department of Foreign Affairs, Mr. President.
Yeah. Mr. President, sa akin po, Senator Tolentino, more basic and more layman, at one point in time po kasi, nag-present po ang agency, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, Namria ho ba yung gumagawa ng mga official maps natin, nag-present sa Duterte government. So yung nakikita nating mapa na nasa mga schools, na nasa national bookstore, siguro pag ginugol mo Treaty of Paris, may makikita kang mapa tapos may lines across the Philippines. So hinihingi po nung agency na yon na palitan na natin at sundin na natin yung UNCLOS in terms of yung maritime zone, EEZ, etc. Ang desisyon ni President Duterte noon is dapat may input yung legislature and maraming experts. Bakit po? Kasi if you will look at our initial interpretation ng Treaty of Paris, everything inside those lines, territory natin. Pero when we confronted the US, or at least discussed, not necessarily confronted, about kung yung Section 5 ng Mutual Defense Treaty ay matri-trigger kapag ka may mga nangyayari sa loob ng lines na yon, ang sabi ng US, lines lang daw yon ng Treaty of Paris, pero that doesn't mean daw na territory natin yung nasa loob. Kasi take note po, the US is pushing that we recognize, we uphold, we pursue the arbitral award. The US is pushing every other parties to respect UNCLOS, but the US is not a signatory sa UNCLOS. At ang stand ng US is that hindi natin territorial waters yon. Kasi ang, kung hindi ako nagkakamali, of course, I cannot speak for the US, but basically what they're saying is freedom of navigation and freedom of yung paglalagay ng underground cables, etc., ang main interest ng US. Okay. So dumating naman itong mga batas tungkol sa baseline at pumirma tayo sa UNCLOS. So let me go to something technical. If you read national territory, the national territory comprises the Philippine archipelago with all the islands and waters embraced therein, and all other territories over which the Philippines has sovereignty or jurisdiction, consisting of its terrestrial, fluvial, and aerial domains, including its territorial sea, the seabed, the subsoil, the insular shelves, and other submarine areas, the waters around, between, and connecting the islands of the archipelago, regardless of their breadth and dimension, form part of the internal waters of the Philippines. So, ito, kung hindi ako nagkakamali po, pareho naman po to sa two constitutions that, tama ba ako, Senator Coco, Minority Leader? Nasa 35 and sa 73 constitution, basically, ganun na rin yung territory, di ba? Basically, it did not naman take out anything, no? So, ang interpretation natin before is that all of those, including the water inside that lines sa Treaty of Paris, by the way, no, I actually saw the book ng Treaty of Paris. May mapa talaga na nandun sa loob ng libro ng Treaty of Paris, no? So, but if you look naman at the state policies, meron isang section dito na, di ba, kapag ka treaties, the state shall... I'll just look for it. B- basically, di ba, pag decisions ng Supreme Court, it's part of the rule of the land, treaties are considered laws. So when we adopted UNCLOS, ang UNCLOS kasi, again, very technical, iba yung territorial seas, iba yung EEZ, di ba, etc. So ang nakita ko dun sa wisdom nung decision ni President Duterte to let it be muna is that sometimes, being not exact benefits us. So that in the future, hindi bound ang ating kamay kung ano ang claim natin dyan sa mga tubig natin. So my question is, sorry for the long introduction, Your Honor, I think you understand naman why. So if we pass this proposal that you worked a lot on, what will be the effect in terms of Treaty of Paris versus UNCLOS?
Mr. President, the Treaty of Paris, since it was referred to in our, you mentioned the Constitution, UNCLOS, the same, which is part of our laws by virtue of our being a signatory, it shall also form part of the laws of the land, will not in any way be affected, Mr. President. The understanding of this representation is that what would be strengthened is the entitlements given to us by virtue of UNCLOS, which we have to claim, which we have to practically legislate domestically and show to the entire world that we are claiming this, we are claiming the contiguous zone, we are claiming the territorial sea, we are claiming the breadth of the continental shelf, as well as, Mr. President, the results of the 2000 arbitral award would likewise be placed in a domestic law, which is part of our own adherence and implementation of whatever entitlements we got by virtue of the said 2016 arbitral award. Mr. President, in effect, we lose nothing. We gain a lot. We gain the acceptance of the international community insofar as our marine entitlements would be concerned, and we strengthen our position vis-a-vis other claimant states. I would not mention the state actor now, and it would, by incorporation, even strengthen our domestic laws constitutionally, Mr. President.
Mr. President, thank you for that answer. And let me initially tell you, but may I be allowed to submit a position paper later on, just for the record. But initially, let me put on the record which of your answer I strongly agree with and where I have some concerns. I really admire the gentleman for pushing to strengthen our position, because in a ongoing dispute, even if you say that zero yung basis nung ka-dispute mo, may dispute. Diba? So I'm not using the word claim kasi some people will say, no, China has no claim. Walang basis ang dash line, etc. But when you say you have a dispute, it doesn't mean that merong kang legal leg to stand on. So for example, if I say now, I am disputing the pagiging minority leader ni Senator Coco, but I never stood up and asked for a vote. I do not have one or two more votes. So it would be fair for Senator Coco to say that there's no claim from Senator Cayetano because he doesn't have a vote. He didn't ask for a vote. He didn't even ask the session, di ba? He could also say, I mean, it would be grammatically correct also, or it would be correct to say there's no dispute. It's only in his mind, di ba? But if I go around the senators, if I go around the media and saying, no, and then I suddenly stand up, talo pa rin ako, let's say 2-1 or 2-all, and then the Senate President says na siya pa rin, I mean, we will not hindi natin po sisisihin ang dyaryo kung sasabihin ng dyaryo may dispute. Pero it would be okay for Senator Pimentel, our minority leader, to write the paper to say na walang legal basis si Alan, na-decide na yan. Let's respect the rule of the majority. Let's respect, di ba? So my point is, if you look, there are more, what's the right word? Not islands. There are more features in our EEZ that are held and even militarized by Vietnam and Malaysia than China. So actually, this is a multi-country, not a bilateral, but a multilateral dispute. So let me just say that anything that strengthens our position is most welcome because mahaba to at mabigat tong mga kailangan nating harapin. No? Okay. Now, regarding where I do not disagree at this point, Your Honor, but I have some concerns. Kasi po dun sa Treaty of Paris, ang ating stand nung araw ay completely territory natin yan. Pero dun kasi sa UNCLOS, depende sa area. No? Of course, if it's outside the lines already, EEZ, pabor din sa atin yun. Kasi dati parang outside the lines, quiet lahat dahil medyo bago pa naman yung relatively new compared to empires of the 15th century, for example, ang law of the seas. No? But may konting concern na kung from territory, magiging may rights na lang tayo, whether economic or... Kasi sovereign rights and sovereignty are two different things. Diba? Sovereignty, territory mo yon. Sovereign rights, meaning may karapatan ka lang, pero may karapatan din yung mga ibang bansa. And I'll give you an example, Mr. President. No? I was asked, I'm not at liberty because I didn't ask him if I can disclose his name. But in one of the conferences for UNCLOS in Singapore, I had a side meeting with one of an expert, no? He's American Singaporean, and he asked me, "Sino ba nanalo ng award?" Of course, I was quiet because parang trick question, parang alam naman natin lahat Pilipinas ang nanalo, no? Pero so I quietly said, "The Philippines won," and he said, "Well, you won a lot of points, but in Scarborough you used to arrest Vietnamese and Chinese fishermen. But now, in the award, they're saying that it is a traditional fishing ground of all three, Chinese, Vietnamese, and Filipinos. So you cannot arrest them anymore because you're the one who asked for that ruling. So it is not true. And I leave this up to the experts. It's not quite true na winner take all yung arbitral decision and panalo tayo lahat doon. Kasi as far as Scarborough Shoal is concerned, we are now not arresting anymore. Sa Chinese, obvious, because they took control, di ba? We've discussed that in this hall many times. But for example, sa Vietnamese, they're not part of the arbitral award, but they can point to the award and they can say, oh, according to the award, hindi nyo naman to territory eh. Ano nyo to eh? Traditional fishing ground namin ito. So I'm concerned about details like that, whether or not, in fact, adding to our laws will actually strengthen or keep it the same or weaken, di ba? Unless yung ipapasa natin ngang law is stronger than UNCLOS, pero pag gano'n naman ang ginawa natin, stronger in the sense na pabor po sa atin, pero pag ginawa naman natin yon, may problema din sa international community kasi pumirma naman tayo sa UNCLOS. Although, if I'm not mistaken, may reservations din naman tayo. Eh, no? So, but the point being, Mr. President, is I'm quite cautious in anything we pass, whether or not it will actually strengthen our claims, because we really need to look at every single view, di ba? Front view, back view, bird's eye view of this. And hanga talaga ako kay Senator Tolentino. I've been to his office. I've seen him prepare for the bills and everything. Maybe I can ask this, Senator, Mr. President. Sa pag-aaral at pag-bring up mo nito, meron po bang expert na nag-bring up ng concern na baka humina rather than lumakas ang claim natin? Or so far in your journey of ilan years mo na rin po itong tinutulak, no? So you've spent some quite some time on this. So far naman po, yung mga experts are all supportive.
Yes, yeah. Mr. President, if I may hasten to add, looking at the other side of the Philippine archipelago, what this measure would strengthen would be our position vis-a-vis the Benham Rice, Mr. President. Na hindi nabanggit po, Mr. President, kahit doon sa Treaty of Paris, wala po ito sa arbitral ruling, wala po ito sa agam-agam natin noon, kahit po nung pinag-uusapan yung jurisdiction ng Pilipinas. Pero dito po sa Benham Rice, makikita natin, Mr. President, na talagang hindi lang natin to inaangkin. Talagang sinisigurado po natin ito ay atin dahil magkakaroon po ng prolongation ng continental shelf, itong portion pong ito, from Catanduanes to Isabela, na hindi masyadong napapansin, Mr. President. In fact, dito sa ating panukala, ay pinangalanan pa natin ito. Bagamat ito ay napangalanan na noon ng Benham Rice na tinanggap ng United Nations ang ating pag-aari po dito, pinangalanan din po ito through an executive order as a Philippine Rice, yung isang portion. Sa batas pong ito, pinangalanan pa rin natin sangayon po sa suggestion ng mga eksperto na magaling sa lingwahe na talampas ng Pilipinas. So ito pong nandito sa kanan, bahagi ay isang karagdagan na hindi pag-aangkin. Isang karagdagang pagpapakita na talagang atin ito. At ito po ay meron ng recognition ng United Nations. At pag napasa po itong batas na ito at isasubmit pa natin sa United Nations, double imprimatur na po ito, Mr. President. Bininyaga na, kinumpilan pa, yes. Na atin talaga yon, Mr. President. And if I may add, Mr. President, to add to the narrative a while ago, ang Amerika po, bagamat hindi sila bahagi ng UNCLOS, noong 1994 po, pumirma po si President Bill Clinton doon sa UNCLOS. Subalit, hindi po ito naratipikahan ng US Senate. Subalit, napakarami pong bahagi ng UNCLOS, halos lahat, na lalong-lalo na yung mga principles, general principles of UNCLOS, were already accepted by the White House even before the adoption of the Third Law of the Sea. If I'm not mistaken, it's either President Truman or President Roosevelt, either Roosevelt 1 or Roosevelt 2, na inangkin din nila at kinilala yung karapatan ng ibang bansa, lalo dun sa Gulf of Mexico at maging sa Atlantic Ocean, kung hanggang saan yung bahagda ng kanilang karapatang mangisda. So, Mr. President, just to answer the question again, wala pa ho akong ekspertong nagbigay ng agam-agam na baka humina yung posisyon natin. Subalit, in practical terms, Mr. President, this measure will set clear the parameters for administrative agencies similar to NAMRIA, which was mentioned by Senator Cayetano a while ago, and to include others, Coast Guard, BIFAR, to perform their functions in the field for securing our maritime domain, as well as perhaps, Mr. President, it will ensure that our country will assert and exercise our rights, not just with hanggang dito sa 200 nautical miles, but it will lay the basis for yung napag-usapan namin sa debate no ni Senator Pimentel, yung extended continental shelf beyond 200 nautical miles. Baka madagdagan pa tayo. Kasi yung prolongation, yung biglang hulog, pinagbibigyan po tayo ng UNCLOS na i-extend pa. So magkakaroon tayo ng, because of this, magkakaroon tayo ng extended continental shelf na mapapadagdag pa, Mr. President. Yeah.
Sir President, two short comments then one question. don't get me wrong, pare-pareho po tayong naninindigan to strengthen our claim. U.S. is a big brother, is a is an ally, is someone we should be able to lean on at all times, is an ally sa international community pagdating dito sa South China Sea. But iba interest nila sa interest natin. So we're saying that atin yan, they're saying hindi sa China yan. Magkaiba yon, no? So we're saying amin yan. So yung certain features dyan, hindi yan China, hindi yan Vietnam, hindi yan Malaysia. Ang sinasabi ng US, hindi sa kanila yan. So ano yung practical effect? For example, lahat ng features na nasa loob ng EEZ natin, nasa loob ba ng EEZ natin, meron ng military establishment ang China, Vietnam at saka Malaysia. Eh, sa pagkaalam ko, pag nagtayo ka ng military establishment sa loob ng territory, halimbawa ng ibang country, normal naman yon sa Mutual Defense Treaty na magte-trigger na dapat yon. But it does not trigger because precisely the US does not recognize yung sa UNCLOS. Style nila yun eh, napipirma ang presidente tapos hindi i-approve ng Senate. Diba? Alam naman natin na leader din ang US sa human rights. Am I pronouncing it right? Yung Nuremberg trials. Isa sila dun sa ano, talagang driving force na yung Hague. Diba? Yung International Criminal Court. Pero hindi sila nag-ratify. So hindi sila membro. So hindi mo pwedeng arestuhin ang mga military nila, no? I mean, Superpowers Act, I'm not judging, I'm just stating a fact, no? So that's my first point. Kasi we, in passing this law, hindi pa rin i-recognize ng US yung sinasabi nating atin na talaga dito. Ang sasabihin lang nila, hindi sa China yan. Okay. Second point that I want to make, Mr. President, is that that's the problem when yung sa international law is up to interpretation. So when President Obama went to Japan then the Philippines, napansin talaga ng media, sinabi niya sa Japan na kapag kayong Senkaku Islands o yung islands na may dispute, eh, gumawa ng masama ang China or mag-invade or pumasok, automatic yung Section 5 ng MDT ng Japan at saka ng US. Pero sa Pilipinas, explicitly sinabi ni President Obama, hindi automatic. Hindi automatic, di ba? Yan ay later on clarify ni President Trump at ni President Biden, and at least for this next election, it's either President Biden or President Trump so far. But 4 years after their next election, we're not sure if the next US president will say that that is part of the Mutual Defense Treaty or not. But that's another matter, Mr. President. I agree that the renegotiation of a decades-old Mutual Defense Treaty in a world that is so different from after World War II has to be taken a second look at, di ba? But ang point ko, hindi treaty ally ng US ang Vietnam, hindi treaty ally ng US ang Malaysia, pero makikita mo, it's to their interest na maging kaibigan nila lahat ng claimants against China. Eh, it's to our interest sana na ang big brothers natin internationally, yung claim natin. Kasi EEZ na natin yan eh. Mm-hmm. Wala sa labas ng EEZ natin itong mga ginawa ng Malaysia, Vietnam at saka ng China. Nasa loob ng EEZ natin. So this is my last point that we'll just try to clarify. So are we saying now that anything that was considered territorial waters under the Treaty of Paris will not be downgraded with this law now? So, kung dati, ito yung drawing around the country at lahat yan ay territorial waters. Ngayon ba, liliit ang territorial waters natin o hanggang doon pa rin sa linya ng, ano, ng Treaty of Paris?
Mr. President, if I don't have a copy here of the Philippine Constitution, historic rights and legal titles previously mentioned in the 73 and 35 Constitution, I think are no longer written in the 1987 Constitution. Thank you. I just had my copy here, and this was mentioned a while ago, narrated a while ago by the good gentleman from Taguig. But Mr. President, even if it's not mentioned, I surmise, Mr. President, that we were guided by a recent Supreme Court case, Magallona versus Ermita, which wherein the Supreme Court stated all other territories over which the Philippines has sovereignty or jurisdiction found in the 1973 Constitution, all territories belonging to the Philippines by historic right and title found in 1970 covers areas linked to the Philippines with varying degrees of certainty. And the Supreme Court enumerated. I think, Mr. President, our claims under the Treaty of Paris will not be diluted. I think it will even be strengthened. It is just us complying and reconciling our domestic laws with international law.
Yeah.
As a member of the global community in good standing, Mr. President. So I would not even dare mention a claim being made by our country in another neighboring country. But nandun pa rin po, Mr. President.
Mr. President, I was never good in math and science or that excited sa elementary at high school, but I did like social studies. So actually, I was campaigning during that constitution. I think I was 13 years old, 16. And yun nga po, wala na dyan yung historic rights. Pero according to the framers of the constitution, even if they took it out, it's still embedded. Yes, we didn't want to ruffle feathers with Malaysia, kaya hindi nilagay yon, but considered na tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang ating claim doon. No? But yun nga po ang problema, parang may discrepancy between a... So under po itong pinapasa nyo, ilan kilometers po ang territorial waters from land, for example?
I have
from the baseline.
It's the you're referring to the territory. 12 nautical miles.
12 miles. But hindi po ba sa Treaty of Paris lampas po ng 12 nautical miles yon. So from our interpretation before na yon ay territorial sea, ay ngayon magiging na yon, EEC na yon.
Correct. If it's beyond the contiguous a zone, Mr. President.
Yeah. So anyway, I'll leave it there because actually, pumirma tayo sa UNCLOS. Eh. But just to point out that I think President Duterte was correct na bago natin galawin yung mapa doon, examine, re-examine, at anong mas pabor sa atin. No? Of course, when we say anong mas pabor sa atin, Senator, Mr. President, kasama din doon yung getting the consensus sa international community, di ba? Kasi nga, pwede natin ipasa atin lahat yun eh. Pero it will spell out war between all of our neighbors and or isolate us. De, hindi rin nakakabuti. No? So really, we have to find a way of protecting what is ours, but also balancing the proper relations with our neighbors. We've so far done that with Malaysia, for example, di ba? We have a dispute with them when it comes to Sabah. They will not agree with that. Sasabihin nila tapos na yung dispute na yan. But as to my example with China or with Senator Pimentel, by the way, there's no dispute. He's the undisputed minority leader of our Senate. I was just making an example. However, recognize naman ng Malaysia na live yung dispute sa South China Sea. No? So again, Mr. President, can I congratulate the senator and maybe just to give a time to whether a position paper or as a part of my explanation of the vote. Sobra lang po tong technical, kaya napakahirap pong isa-isahin talaga. That's why I sincerely admire the gentleman for tackling this and for studying it and spending much time for it. I really hope that the ating mahal na mga kababayan, especially the voters, see that you went an extra mile, you know, to stand up for our territory, for our rights. Congratulations, Senator Tolentino. Thank you very much, Mr. President, for this time.
Salamat po, Mr. President.
Thank you very much.
To the gentleman from Taguig as well, the former Secretary of Department of Foreign Affairs.
Yes, thank you very much, Senator Allen, and of course, to